Hello? Water pump. It is important component of the cooling system, and it should be checked occasionally. In my car, you can see that there is some clearance in bearings of the pump, and a metallic grinding sound is heard when engine is running. So, I decided to replace the pump with the original one. This pump has already been used, and I must check it before installing it. Check the pump shaft for smooth rotation in its bearings and freedom from sideways play. A small amount of hand play is permissible. I will have to open the packaging to get the gaskets for the pump. New gaskets will be needed anyway. Gaskets fit. Cardboard spacer. Let's start removing the old pump. First, I need to disconnect the alternator. Alternator splashed with antifreeze from an old pump. Disconnect the fan belt. To drain the coolant, I need a place container under the car. Disconnect the lower hose that connects the engine and radiator. I also disconnect the bolt that secures the tube that goes from the pump to the hose. I usually use blue antifreeze, but as the container is filled, it can be seen that the antifreeze is not the first freshness. I unscrew the four half-inch bolts that secure the fan. Now I will unscrew the pump. It is fitted with four half-inch bolts to the engine block. The lower bolts are shorter than the top ones. This is to screw each bolt into place later. It seems to me that the tube is frozen. To disconnect it, I need to clean it with a brush. And of course, I can disconnect it without using WD-40. And now, difficult and important moment, to clean the mating faces. The gasket does not want to detach from the engine. I have to clean all the old sealant. I also use steel brush. Yes, I need to disconnect the alternator holder. This pipe is a little rusty. I decided to try using a razor blade to clean the mating faces. With the help of a mirror, I can see those places where it is impossible to look. And I continue to clean to perfect cleanliness. It seems to me that the surface is enough to clean. What a pump! Half-inch bolts for fitting the pump. You can see that bolts slides through the pump and cardboard spacer, and pump ready to installation. The first bolt to be screwed, this is the upper left bolt, and then press the pump up to the cylinder head and screw the upper right side bolt. Make sure that the seal rings at the water pipes are not damaged, and press in the pipes carefully when fitting. Tightening the pump bolts. New rubber ring for side pipe. Tighten the clamp of the lower radiator hose. Alternator bottom bolt. Screwing, but not tighten before tighten the fan belt. Fan belt adjusting bolt. Install the fan, tighten the fan belt. Fill cooling liquid. Heat temperature controller to maximum. Also need to make sure that there are no leaks anywhere. Check coolant level. When you have filled the system, run the engine for several minutes at different speeds. If necessary, top up with more coolant after this, and then fit the expansion tank cap. After driving for a short time, check the coolant level again, and if necessary, top up with more coolant. It takes some time before the system is completely free of air. I really like this book. It's written in simple language and understandable. If you like it, be sure to click thumbs up. Thanks for your attention. Thank you.